Hello everyone. A new leader has emerged to represent not only the minority Muslims but also the backward and otherwise neglected sections of the majority Hindu community, that's scheduled caste and scheduled tribes. Its leader Asaduddin Owaisi, a qualified barrister from Lincoln's University London, is garnering across North India, but in truth his star has been on the rise for some time. Slowly but steadily, the Hyderabad MP has sought to expand the AIMIM's footprint, having first found success in Maharashtra. In the latest Maharashtra Assembly elections, the AIMIM matched its 2014 performance, winning 2 seats. However, it nearly doubled its votes percentage. Having contested on 44 of the 288 seats in the state, the AIMIM placed second on 4 others as well. The party's success in Maharashtra and Bihar has only emboldened the former lawyer to spread his party's wings even further, extending into Uttar Pradesh and West Bengal. In West Bengal, Owaisi already has a history with Chief Minister Mamata Banerjee, with the two having been on the same side of the political battle during the Singur agitation. However, since then, CM Banerjee has woken to the threat the AIMIM could pose against her Trinamool Congress, which relies heavily on the 30% of Muslim vote in the state's 294 member assembly. With the BJP making inroads into the state, CM Banerjee has publicly warned her constituents of Owaisi, calling him one of the biggest allies of the BJP. Riding high on Bihar victory, where he bagged 5 assembly seats in Simanchal, Owaisi has set his eyes on West Bengal, where he feels his party got a bright future. Although the Congress and opposition parties call him a spoiled sport, as he successfully luring away minority vote bank from them and thus helped the BJP garner the entire Hindu votes. Yet Asaduddin Owaisi wonders, what's wrong if I ask my community members to vote for him when the Saffron Party can? In that backdrop, undoubtedly Asaduddin Owaisi is fast emerging as one of the tallest minority leaders in India, which many opposition leaders unable to stomach, especially the country's oldest party, Congress. Owaisi did not mince words when he accused the Congress for misusing the minority Muslims as vote bank with some doles, but in reality has done nothing for the community. Interestingly, the suppressed sections like the SCs and STs too, who were Congress supporters, now leaning away and looking towards the young Owaisi to render justice for them. The emergence of Owaisi, in fact, may help BJP more than the opposition. If the opposition wants to challenge the surge of BJP, it should strike a deal with AIMIM and follow coalition dharma by giving away deserving slice of cake to Owaisi. Or else, Owaisi may become unstoppable, that's for sure. Thank you for watching Zubi News.